When thinking about estate planning, a lot of my clients have come to me and said, which is more powerful, a will or a trust? Well, interestingly enough, the trump card of estate planning is actually the beneficiary designations. Now, beneficiary designations allow you to transfer certain assets, such as the proceeds of a life insurance policy, an IRA, a 401k, to a person or entity that you choose to receive the money. They're called the beneficiary. Now, beneficiary designations can overrule whatever your will or trust says, which is kind of interesting. Your will could leave your money to one person, but if the beneficiary designation on one of these assets names someone else, that's the person that will get your money. There are certainly some pros and cons of using beneficiary designations, however. Some of the pros are they're easy to set up and they cost nothing. It avoids probate as the assets pass by designation. You own the property until your death and you can change the beneficiary at any time as long as you're competent and still alive, of course. Now, there are cons to beneficiary designations. The proceeds may not pass entirely as you wish. Not all assets have the ability to name beneficiaries. Your retirement plan, for instance, might not allow you to name more than one beneficiary, and you lose control of the funds after your death. If you want control for other people after that, you need to have a trust, and you need to name the trust as the beneficiary of certain assets. When naming beneficiaries, the other thing to keep in mind is it's important to always name a contingent beneficiary, at least in most cases, just in case the primary beneficiary is not alive when something happens to you. Still confused? Maybe a good time to check with your estate planning attorney and update those wills, trust, and beneficiary designations.